Hello to you, my dear future educator. This time we are already in the part 2 of our review for professional education. Before we will going to start, please don't forget to subscribe my channel. Are you ready? Here we go. Number 1. Miss Lucero is a newly appointed teacher. The principal handed a copy of the teacher's code of ethics. Which could have been the motive of the principal? A. Acquaint her with principles of moral behavior, conduct and relationship in the practice of profession. B. Make her aware of the principles and rules prescribed under the authority of the state. C. Familiarize her with the generally accepted customs of right living in a society. D. Provides her a set of rules and regulation to observe in school. Miss Lucero is a newly appointed teacher. The principal handed a copy of the teacher's code of ethics. Which could have been the motive of the principal? A. Acquaint her with principles of moral behavior, conduct and relationship in the practice of profession. B. Make her aware of the principles and rules prescribed under the authority of the state. C. Familiarize her with the generally accepted customs of right living in a society. D. Provides her a set of rules and regulation to observe in school. Number 2. Miss Pulido, a grade 1 teacher, has observed that her pupils respond actively to various class activities. Why are her pupils teachable? A. Their economic competence makes them receptive to education. B. Their independence makes them more obedient. C. They are more open to experience. D. Any of 3 is correct. Miss Pulido, a grade 1 teacher, has observed that her pupils respond actively to various class activities. Why are her pupils teachable? A. Their economic competence makes them receptive to education. B. Their independence makes them more obedient. C. They are more open to experience. D. Any of 3 is correct. Number 3. Education and culture tend to be cyclical. Which of the following clearly explains this statement? A. Culture is influenced by the school and the school is shaped by the school. B. Culture influences the school function as change agent. C. Culture is primarily transmitted by the school. D. Culture is learned basically from the school. Education and culture tend to be cyclical. Which of the following clearly explains this statement? A. Culture is influenced by the school and the school is shaped by the school. B. Culture influences the school function as change agent. C. Culture is primarily transmitted by the school. D. Culture is learned basically from the school. Number 4. Mrs. Rubio, a kinder teacher, observed that the preschool children have generally short attention and interest span. What kind of class activities should she select for them? A. Long but interesting. B. Both easy and difficult. C. Challenging and interesting. D. Short, varied and interesting. Mrs. Rubio, a kinder teacher, observed that the preschool children have generally short attention and interest span. What kind of class activities should she select for them? A. Long but interesting. B. Both easy and difficult. C. Challenging and interesting. D. Short, varied and interesting. Number 5. As part of their guitar lesson, Mrs. Arenita, the guitar teacher, scheduled the young beginners to play for 30 minutes daily 3 times per week. In terms of psychomotor learning, Mrs. Arenita's action illustrates A. Skill perfecting. B. Skilled performance. C. Distributed practice. D. Mass practice. As part of their guitar lesson, Mrs. Arenita, the guitar teacher, scheduled the young beginners to play for 30 minutes daily 3 times per week. In terms of psychomotor learning, Mrs. Arenita's action illustrates A. Skill perfecting. B. Skilled performance. C. Distributed practice. D. Mass practice. Number 6. Ms. Manzano is badly in need of money. A rich parent of her pupil has offered However, the pupil is a candidate for failure. What could be the best action for Ms. Manzano to take? A. Refuse politely the offer and inform parents concerned that teachers are not allowed to receive money or favors from parents. B. Accept the money on condition that the parent promise to keep everything confidential. C. Accept the money but make it clear that this is not a condition for passing his child. D. Refuse the money and report the parent to the principal and to the PTA board. Ms. Manzano is badly in need of money. A rich parent of her pupil has offered. However, the pupil is a candidate for failure. What could be the best action for Ms. Manzano to take? A. Refuse politely the offer and inform parents concerned that teachers are not allowed to receive money or favors from parents. B. Accept the money on condition that the parent promise to keep everything confidential. C. Accept the money but make it clear that this is not a condition for passing his child. D. Refuse the money and report the parent to the principal and to the PTA board. Number 7. Miss Denko taped one of the Sesame Street series and slowed this to class. Which of the following generalization under which the utilization of Sesame Street as an instructional materials was developed? A. Children learn by observing and imitating. B. Instruction should be reduced to entertainment. C. The TV teacher is accepted by younger children. D. Indirect methods should be used to teach cognitive skills. Miss Denko taped one of the Sesame Street series and slowed this to class. Which of the following generalization under which the utilization of Sesame Street as an instructional materials was developed? A. Children learn by observing and imitating. B. Instruction should be reduced to entertainment. C. The TV teacher is accepted by younger children. D. Indirect methods should be used to teach cognitive skills. Number 8. The Philippine Education Act of 1982 defines the areas of concern of the three levels of the educational system. Which is the mission of elementary education? A. An enlightened, disciplined, creative and productive citizen. B. Modern and up-to-date methods and materials. C. An effective and efficient teacher. D. Relevant and quality curriculum. The Philippine Education Act of 1982 defines the areas of concern of the three levels of the educational system. Which is the mission of elementary education? A. An enlightened, disciplined, creative and productive citizen. B. Modern and up-to-date methods and materials. C. An effective and efficient teacher. D. Relevant and quality curriculum. Number 9. Mr. De Jesus, a teacher in Araling Panlipunan, strongly believes in education as agent of social and cultural change. What would be the emphasis of his lessons? A. Current social issues and problems of the student's own community. B. Social life of the past and the far away. C. Political history of the great countries. D. Historical and geographical facts. Mr. De Jesus, a teacher in Araling Panlipunan, strongly believes in education as agent of social and cultural change. What would be the emphasis of his lessons? A. Current social issues and problems of the student's own community. B. Social life of the past and the far away. C. Political history of the great countries. D. Historical and geographical facts. Number 10. Ms. Sagmit has shifted from a very traditional to contemporary notion of an experiential learning in her teaching. She always finds means and ways by which students learn with and from each other by attempting to identify and then implement solutions to their problems and opportunities. What kind of learning is emphasized by Ms. Sagmit? A. Action learning. B. Self-learning. C. Group learning. D. Personal learning. Ms. Sagmit has shifted from a very traditional to contemporary notion of an experiential learning in her teaching. She always finds means and ways by which students learn with and from each other by attempting to identify and then implement solutions to their problems and opportunities. What kind of learning is emphasized by Ms. Sagmit? A. Action learning. B. Self-learning. C. Group learning. D. Personal learning. Number 11. In inquiry, the teacher asks opening questions to invite responses from children which require great range of cognitive skills. Which opening is most fitted for inquiry lesson? A. What is the name of the movable part of an airplane wing? B. How many legs does a grasshopper have? C. Why do birds fly south in the winter? D. Which planet is closest to the sun? In inquiry, the teacher asks opening questions to invite responses from children which require great range of cognitive skills. Which opening is most fitted for inquiry lesson? A. What is the name of the movable part of an airplane wing? B. How many legs does a grasshopper have? C. Why do birds fly south in the winter? D. Which planet is closest to the sun? Number 12. Miss Orensha has been rated a very effective teacher. Which intellectual trait does Miss Orensha manifest? A. Well-groomed. B. Tolerance. C. Widely read. D. Intellectual honest. Miss Orensha has been rated a very effective teacher. Which intellectual trait does Miss Orensha manifest? A. Well-groomed. B. Tolerance. C. Widely read. D. Intellectual honest. Number 13. The function of schooling is determined largely by the generally accepted social conception of education. What is the function of the school curriculum in a school that regards education as cultural transmission? A. To serve as a unifying element among social classes. B. To serve a boundary breaking between social classes. C. To serve as an instrument to remove social status stratification. D. To serve as a boundary maintaining structure between social classes. The function of schooling is determined largely by the generally accepted social conception of education. What is the function of the school curriculum in a school that regards education as cultural transmission? A. To serve as a unifying element among social classes. B. To serve a boundary breaking between social classes. C. To serve as an instrument to remove social status stratification. D. To serve as a boundary maintaining structure between social classes. Number 14. Rochelle brings all her books to school because she wants to please the teacher and get good grades. To which of the following levels of morality according to Kohlberg does she belong? A. Conventional. B. Pre-conventional. C. Post-conventional. D. Either pre-conventional or conventional. Rochelle brings all her books to school because she wants to please the teacher and get good grades. To which of the following levels of morality according to Kohlberg does she belong? A. Conventional. B. Pre-conventional. C. Post-conventional. D. Either pre-conventional or conventional. Number 15. Mrs. Ledesma is observing Patrick frequently misbehaving every time the class is in session. She believes that every behavior of an individual has its underlying causes. Therefore, what would be her initial reaction towards Patrick's misbehavior? A. Find out why he misbehaves. B. Report him to the principal. C. Talk with his parents. D. Reprimand him. Mrs. Ledesma is observing Patrick frequently misbehaving every time the class is in session. She believes that every behavior of an individual has its underlying causes. Therefore, what would be her initial reaction towards Patrick's misbehavior? A. Find out why he misbehaves. B. Report him to the principal. C. Talk with his parents. D. Reprimand him. Number 16. Ms. Timball is using cooperative learning approaches in her social science lessons. She is quite successful in establishing a cooperative ethics characterized by a safe, caring community learners. What will be her initial step in order to successfully implement cooperative learning approaches? A. Identify academic and social objectives. B. Determine group size and membership. C. Establish positive interdependence. D. Arrange the learning environment. Ms. Timbell is using cooperative learning approaches in her social science lessons. She is quite successful in establishing a cooperative ethics characterized by a safe, caring community learners. What will be her initial step in order to successfully implement cooperative learning approaches? A. Identify academic and social objectives. B. Determine group size and membership. C. Establish positive interdependence. D. Arrange the learning environment. Number 17. Ms. Zuljata upholds that the needs and interest of the learner should be the basis of his educational program, which is more likely to be strongly reflected in Ms. Zuljata's plan. A. Objectives that are focused on social judgment. B. Objectives that are activity-centered. C. Objectives that are social nutrition. D. Objectives that are child-centered. Ms. Zuljata upholds that the needs and interest of the learner should be the basis of his educational program, which is more likely to be strongly reflected in Ms. Zuljata's plan. A. Objectives that are focused on social judgment. B. Objectives that are activity-centered. C. Objectives that are social nutrition. D. Objectives that are child-centered. Number 18. Mr. Vilayana is a newly appointed teacher. The principal advised him to avoid any conduct which discredit the teaching profession. A. Writing anonymous letters. B. Revealing confidential information to authorities concerned. C. Assigning underserved grades. D. Joining social drinking and gambling session. Mr. Vilayana is a newly appointed teacher. The principal advised him to avoid any conduct which discredit the teaching profession. A. Writing anonymous letters. B. Revealing confidential information to authorities concerned. C. Assigning underserved grades. D. Joining social drinking and gambling session. Number 19. In education as agent of modernization, the curriculum tends to focus on well-defined orientation, which described best the curriculum in this sociological views. A. Future-oriented. B. Past-oriented. C. Present-oriented. D. Tradition-oriented. In education as agent of modernization, the curriculum tends to focus on well-defined orientation, which described best the curriculum in this sociological views. A. Future-oriented. B. Past-oriented. C. Present-oriented. D. Tradition-oriented. Number 20. Ms. de Guzman is a firm believer of Rousseau theory that education should be according to nature. To be in accord with nature, which of the following will Ms. de Guzman do? A. Treat the child as little adults. B. Treat the child as a noble savage. C. Treat the child as though he was little adult. D. Treat the child according to the laws of growth and development. Ms. de Guzman is a firm believer of Rousseau theory that education should be according to nature. To be in accord with nature, which of the following will Ms. de Guzman do? A. Treat the child as little adults. B. Treat the child as a noble savage. C. Treat the child as though he was little adult. D. Treat the child according to the laws of growth and development. Number 21. The early Filipinos learned the rudiments of domestic work from their parents. Which method was used? A. Trial and error method. B. Indoctrination. C. Tell me, show me method. D. Experimental method. The early Filipinos learned the rudiments of domestic work from their parents. Which method was used? A. Trial and error method. B. Indoctrination. C. Tell me, show me method. D. Experimental method. Number 22. Following Piaget's theory of cognitive development, Mrs. De Leon provides her students varied activities that enable them to classify objects according to more than one variable, rank order items in logical series, and understand that amounts of mass or liquid do not change because their shape does. The development tasks can be expected to be performed by A. elementary school children, B. high school students, C. college students, D. preschoolers. Following Piaget's theory of cognitive development, Mrs. De Leon provides her students varied activities that enable them to classify objects according to more than one variable, rank order items in logical series, and understand that amounts of mass or liquid do not change because their shape does. The development tasks can be expected to be performed by A. elementary school children, B. high school students, C. college students, D. preschoolers. Number 23. You observed that your principal is playing favorites. Some of your co-teachers can go home ahead of official time and can even choose the best schedule. What would be your appropriate reaction to this situation? A. Try to win your principal and ask to be given the same privilege next time. B. Give warning to the principal's favorites that they'd rather be careful about their behavior. C. Follow strictly your official time, do not be influenced by your co-teacher's behavior. D. Report both your principal's behavior and your co-teacher's violation of official time to your supervisor. You observed that your principal is playing favorites. Some of your co-teachers can go home ahead of official time and can even choose the best schedule. What would be your appropriate reaction to this situation? A. Try to win your principal and ask to be given the same privilege next time. B. Give warning to the principal's favorites that they'd rather be careful about their behavior. C. Follow strictly your official time, do not be influenced by your co-teacher's behavior. D. Report both your principal's behavior and your co-teacher's violation of official time to your supervisor. Number 24. Grace usually used the correct plural form of loaves and later used the plural but incorrect form loafs. Which best account for learning? A. Rule theory, B. reception theory, C. discovery learning theory, D. conditioning theory. Grace usually used the correct plural form of loaves and later used the plural but incorrect form loafs. Which best account for learning? A. Rule theory, B. reception theory, C. discovery learning theory, D. conditioning theory. Number 25. Mrs. Martinez asked her pupils to use the atlas in correcting their answers to test in geography. Which teaching principle is exemplified by such teacher's action? A. Organize material into appropriate learning units, B. provide for correct corresponding on the first trial, C. encourage for independent evaluation, D. arrange for appropriate practice. Mrs. Martinez asked her pupils to use the atlas in correcting their answers to test in geography. Which teaching principle is exemplified by such teacher's action? A. Organize material into appropriate learning units, B. provide for correct corresponding on the first trial, C. encourage for independent evaluation, D. arrange for appropriate practice. Number 26. Marielle differentiates between bungalow, nipa hut, a wooden two-story structure and apartment and treat them as house. Marielle now has attained a concept of house at the A. formal level, B. classificatory level, C. identity level, D. concrete level. Marielle differentiates between bungalow, nipa hut, a wooden two-story structure and apartment and treat them as house. Marielle now has attained a concept of house at the A. formal level, B. classificatory level, C. identity level, D. concrete level. Number 27. Michael has been caught cheating in the examination several times. As always, he would give her a very repentant, "I'm sorry," Give me another chance. What makes I'm sorry, give me another chance appealing for fair-minded teacher? A. It makes students acknowledge wrongdoing and promise to do something about it. B. It provokes a battle, giving the teacher greater firepower. C. It places a premium on being liked and disliked. D. It makes teacher feel helpless and guilty. Michael has been caught cheating in the examination several times. As always, he would give her a very repentant, "I'm sorry, give me another chance." What makes "I'm sorry, give me another chance" appealing for fair-minded teacher? A. It makes students acknowledge wrongdoing and promise to do something about it. B. It provokes a battle, giving the teacher greater firepower. C. It places a premium on being liked and disliked. D. It makes teacher feel helpless and guilty. Number 28. Such psychological characteristics as the helplessness of nursery kids, the inborn curiosity of the primary school pupils, the social consciousness of high school students, and the practical purpose of college students establish that A. The individual has certain characteristics of each level of development that makes him educable. B. Education is a basic need of the individual at every level of development. C. Education is psychologically based. D. Education is adjustment and adaptation. Such psychological characteristics as the helplessness of nursery kids, the inborn curiosity of the primary school pupils, the social consciousness of high school students, and the practical purpose of college students establish that A. The individual has certain characteristics of each level of development that makes him educable. B. Education is a basic need of the individual at every level of development. C. Education is psychologically based. D. Education is adjustment and adaptation. Number 29. Mrs. Zobel, a home economics teacher, constantly gives verbal guidance to her pupils while practicing a sewing skill. What is the value of giving verbal guidance in improving pupils' learning behavior? A. Directs pupils' attention to more adequate and better techniques and those already acquired. B. Promote growth of interest of pupils into the learning tasks. C. Improves the informational feedback. D. Facilitates perfection skills. Mrs. Zobel, a home economics teacher, constantly gives verbal guidance to her pupils while practicing a sewing skill. What is the value of giving verbal guidance in improving pupils' learning behavior? A. Directs pupils' attention to more adequate and better techniques and those already acquired. B. Promote growth of interest of pupils into the learning tasks. C. Improves the informational feedback. D. Facilitates perfection skills. Number 30. Mrs. Ayala has observed that several of her pupils do not show respect for school authorities. Which of the following would best help her? A. Use more rewards initially with the pupils who have shown respect for authorities for the first time. B. Maintain the same level of rewards for all pupils who have shown respect for authorities. C. Hold rewards until everyone in her class manifests respect for authorities. D. Vary levels of reward for those who have shown respect for authorities. Mrs. Ayala has observed that several of her pupils do not show respect for school authorities. Which of the following would best help her? A. Use more rewards initially with the pupils who have shown respect for authorities for the first time. B. Maintain the same level of rewards for all pupils who have shown respect for authorities. C. Hold rewards until everyone in her class manifests respect for authorities. D. Vary levels of reward for those who have shown respect for authorities. Number 31. Anjali is learning to change fraction to percentage. Every time she answers correctly the practice exercise, his teacher gives her a peso. In this situation, which of the above is the operant? A. Peso. B. Anjali. C. The practice exercises. D. The act of changing fraction to percentage. Anjali is learning to change fraction to percentage. Every time she answers correctly the practice exercise, his teacher gives her a peso. In this situation, which of the above is the operant? A. Peso. B. Anjali. C. The practice exercises. D. The act of changing fraction to percentage. Number 32. Mrs. Libara is a teacher of freshman English. Which development sequence in language development should she follow? A. Discriminates colors, discriminates objects, discriminates words. B. Discriminates objects, discriminates colors, discriminates words. C. Discriminates words, discriminates objects, produce speech. D. Discriminates objects, discriminates words, produce speech. Mrs. Libara is a teacher of freshman English. Which development sequence in language development should she follow? A. Discriminates colors, discriminates objects, discriminates words. B. Discriminates objects, discriminates colors, discriminates words. C. Discriminates words, discriminates objects, produce speech. D. Discriminates objects, discriminates words, produce speech. Number 33. Diane's fear of the doctor most likely can be overcome though. A. Counter conditioning. B. Instrumental learning. C. Generalized reinforcement. D. Spontaneous recovery. Diane's fear of the doctor most likely can be overcome though. A. Counter conditioning. B. Instrumental learning. C. Generalized reinforcement. D. Spontaneous recovery. Number 34. Which of the following principles motivation is applied by a teacher who uses specified comments such as excellent, keep it up, try or do still better? You can do it and you can raise this grade? A. Acquiring information concerning appropriate behaviors is associated with better performance. B. Attending to a learning task is essential in initiating a learning sequence. C. Setting goals require learning tasks at an appropriate difficulty level. D. Intending to achieve success is essential to realistic goal setting. Which of the following principles motivation is applied by a teacher who uses specified comments such as excellent, keep it up, try or do still better? You can do it and you can raise this grade? A. Acquiring information concerning appropriate behaviors is associated with better performance. B. Attending to a learning task is essential in initiating a learning sequence. C. Setting goals require learning tasks at an appropriate difficulty level. D. Intending to achieve success is essential to realistic goal setting. Number 35. A part of Miss Medina's planning in consumers' mathematics is displaying can if diet soft drink, box of milk, 1 pound package of spaghetti, and box of cereal for the unit in ratio, proportion and percentage. What could be the teacher's purpose for this particular planning task in science? A. Gain attention. B. Present stimulus material. C. Elicit desired behavior. D. Stimulate recall of prerequisite. A part of Miss Medina's planning in consumers' mathematics is displaying can if diet soft drink, box of milk, 1 pound package of spaghetti, and box of cereal for the unit in ratio, proportion and percentage. What could be the teacher's purpose for this particular planning task in science? A. Gain attention. B. Present stimulus material. C. Elicit desired behavior. D. Stimulate recall of prerequisite. Number 36. Long before the start of every school year, Mrs. Solis has already started developing her own comprehensive plan based on the recommended curriculum. Which explains best Mrs. Solis' action in relation to the curriculum? A. Planning screened possible differences between the curriculum plan and the implementation process. B. Planning reduces possibilities of getting out of the planned curriculum. C. Planning is entirely dependent on the approved curriculum. D. Planning personalizes the curriculum, making it her own. Long before the start of every school year, Mrs. Solis has already started developing her own comprehensive plan based on the recommended curriculum. Which explains best Mrs. Solis' action in relation to the curriculum? A. Planning screened possible differences between the curriculum plan and the implementation process. B. Planning reduces possibilities of getting out of the planned curriculum. C. Planning is entirely dependent on the approved curriculum. D. Planning personalizes the curriculum, making it her own. Number 37. Miss Campos, a newly appointed teacher, was assigned to teach science in the intermediate grades, for which she has very little background. As a result, she has been experiencing considerable anxiety, both because she is new and because she lacks confidence in the subject where she was assigned. After spending considerable time in planning, she discovered that the use of transparencies will keep the flow of her discussion going. What planning function manifests itself in this teaching situation? A. Planning personalizes the curriculum. B. Planning reduces expenditures of time and effort. C. Planning serves as means or organizing instruction. D. Planning considers the relevance and congruence of contents with objectives. Miss Campos, a newly appointed teacher, was assigned to teach science in the intermediate grades, for which she has very little background. As a result, she has been experiencing considerable anxiety, both because she is new and because she lacks confidence in the subject where she was assigned. After spending considerable time in planning, she discovered that the use of transparencies will keep the flow of her discussion going. What planning function manifests itself in this teaching situation? A. Planning personalizes the curriculum. B. Planning reduces expenditures of time and effort. C. Planning serves as means or organizing instruction. D. Planning considers the relevance and congruence of contents with objectives. Number 38. In any planning process, which variable will strongly affect the teacher's action? A. Content. B. Students. C. Teacher. D. Materials. In any planning process, which variable will strongly affect the teacher's action? A. Content. B. Students. C. Teacher. D. Materials. Number 39. When effective planning allows for revision, adaptation of pre-selected methodologies, activities, materials, and evaluation instrument to meet student needs, the teacher considers A. Success. B. Flexibility. C. Congruence. D. Motivation. When effective planning allows for revision, adaptation of pre-selected methodologies, activities, materials, and evaluation instrument to meet student needs, the teacher considers A. Success. B. Flexibility. C. Congruence. D. Motivation. Number 40. Problem-based learning has been conceptualized in various ways. What is the first essence of this procedure? A. Implement solution. B. Start with a problem. C. Generate possible solution. D. Explore the problem. Problem-based learning has been conceptualized in various ways. What is the first essence of this procedure? A. Implement solution. B. Start with a problem. C. Generate possible solution. D. Explore the problem. Number 41. Panel discussion has its place in almost all objects. Which lesson is most appropriate for panel discussion? A. Structure of atom. B. Occurrence of tides. C. Preparing balanced diets. D. Pros and cons in using antibiotics. Panel discussion has its place in almost all objects. Which lesson is most appropriate for panel discussion? A. Structure of atom. B. Occurrence of tides. C. Preparing balanced diets. D. Pros and cons in using antibiotics. Number 42. In her art class, Ms. De Leon allows her students to draw and paint using varied media. She invites every student to present their finished composition and talk about them. What principle of method is illustrated by the teacher's action? A. Method liberates the earners. B. Method stimulates thinking and reasoning. C. Method provides for individual differences. D. Method provides for growth and development. In her art class, Ms. De Leon allows her students to draw and paint using varied media. She invites every student to present their finished composition and talk about them. What principle of method is illustrated by the teacher's action? A. Method liberates the earners. B. Method stimulates thinking and reasoning. C. Method provides for individual differences. D. Method provides for growth and development. Number 43. Ms. Manalo lacks materials and equipment for several groups to perform an experiment. What alternative method may she use? A. Project. B. Laboratory. C. Experimentation. D. Demonstration. Ms. Manalo lacks materials and equipment for several groups to perform an experiment. What alternative method may she use? A. Project. B. Laboratory. C. Experimentation. D. Demonstration. Number 44. Patricia's parents were killed by the Japanese during the war. Which would be least effective in changing her strongly biased attitude towards the Japanese? A. Using group techniques. B. Providing informative experience. C. Using counter-conditioning techniques. D. Providing for pleasant emotional experience. Patricia's parents were killed by the Japanese during the war. Which would be least effective in changing her strongly biased attitude towards the Japanese? A. Using group techniques. B. Providing informative experience. C. Using counter-conditioning techniques. D. Providing for pleasant emotional experience. Number 45. To make of the consequences of having a big family, the Araling Ban Lai Poonen teacher asked her students to present some situations common in the home of big and small families by group. She gave the students 10 minutes to think and organize before they act out the situations. What technique is used by the teacher? A. Sociodrama. B. Pageant. C. Role-playing. D. Dramatization. To make of the consequences of having a big family, the Araling Ban Lai Poonen teacher asked her students to present some situations common in the home of big and small families by group. She gave the students 10 minutes to think and organize before they act out the situations. What technique is used by the teacher? A. Sociodrama. B. Pageant. C. Role-playing. D. Dramatization. Number 46. Mrs. Varela asked her grade 6 children to narrate some experiences during the recent earthquake before she tackles how earthquakes develops. What process is this? A. Apperception. B. Evaluation. C. Application. D. Motivation. Mrs. Varela asked her grade 6 children to narrate some experiences during the recent earthquake before she tackles how earthquakes develops. What process is this? A. Apperception. B. Evaluation. C. Application. D. Motivation. Number 47. Miss Morales started her lesson with the statement of generalization. Then she asked her pupils to undertake activities to prove the correctness of the generalization before letting her pupils give specific examples or cases. What method did she use? A. Discovery. B. Problem solving. C. Deductive. D. Inductive. Miss Morales started her lesson with the statement of generalization. Then she asked her pupils to undertake activities to prove the correctness of the generalization before letting her pupils give specific examples or cases. What method did she use? A. Discovery. B. Problem solving. C. Deductive. D. Inductive. Number 48. To prove the truth of the concept hair has weight, Mr. Roman grouped his children into four groups. He gave each group a set of materials to perform some experiments which will verify the correctness and wrongness of the concept. The groups were also given activity cards where the procedures from the experiments are indicated. So all the groups performed the experiments, after which they filled up a chart to show the result of such activities. This is an illustration of A. Demonstration method. B. Laboratory method. C. Process approach. D. Discovery approach. To prove the truth of the concept hair has weight, Mr. Roman grouped his children into four groups. He gave each group a set of materials to perform some experiments which will verify the correctness and wrongness of the concept. The groups were also given activity cards where the procedures from the experiments are indicated. So all the groups performed the experiments, after which they filled up a chart to show the result of such activities. This is an illustration of A. Demonstration method. B. Laboratory method. C. Process approach. D. Discovery approach. Number 49. When Elizabeth looked at her textbook, it says that the population of the Philippines is 74 million. When she looked up the World Almanac, it's 65 million. When she referred to the reference books of her sister, she found another data. What does this try to show? A. The textbook serves as a reliable and accurate source of data. B. The textbook should not be regarded as infallible. C. The textbook gives the most accurate data. D. The textbook data are changeable. When Elizabeth looked at her textbook, it says that the population of the Philippines is 74 million. When she looked up the World Almanac, it's 65 million. When she referred to the reference books of her sister, she found another data. What does this try to show? A. The textbook serves as a reliable and accurate source of data. B. The textbook should not be regarded as infallible. C. The textbook gives the most accurate data. D. The textbook data are changeable. Number 50. In what teaching situation can an experiment turn to be a demonstration lesson? A. When few children perform the experiment in front while others observe. B. When children set up a control to test the variable being tested. C. When children gather data before formulating conclusions. D. When children perform the experiment by themselves. In what teaching situation can an experiment turn to be a demonstration lesson? A. When few children perform the experiment in front while others observe. B. When children set up a control to test the variable being tested. C. When children gather data before formulating conclusions. D. When children perform the experiment by themselves.